Hey, what's up, guys? It's Pat. I got another money-making guide for you for World of Warcraft. And what you have to do for this one is solo the trash in Grim Batol. And this is located in Twilight Highlands. I'm showing you guys exactly what you got to do. This is probably one of the harder ones to solo. So not all classes are going to be able to take part in this. But this is seriously one of the best ways to make money in the game that I've found. Much better than farming and a lot less boring as well. But you do have to go pretty quickly to make a good amount of money. I'd say you make between 4,000 and 6,000 gold in an hour. And the money's going to... there is one other important thing that I have to mention. You do need to be a skinner if you want to make the maximum amount of money. There is a lot of stuff to skin in this place. You have to make sure you loot every monster. Only the best soloing classes, though. Hunter, Death Knight, probably some... I don't know what else could do it, really. I don't have all the classes. Maybe Warrior could do it, Paladin. But other than that, there probably aren't too many classes that can actually pull this off. But the amount of money you make is going to be based on how quick you go. You could do... And you have to pull the trash up to the first boss. And that's all you're going to want to do. And you're going to get... You should be able to do a run-in in about... It takes about 15 minutes for each run, so you should be able to run it about 4 times in an hour. Blow all your cooldowns for the quickest way to get here. I haven't even played much Warcraft in a while, so I may be a bit rusty. So you can die here, definitely, even with any class. So you really have to be careful. I'll show you guys how to make sure to be extra careful when you're here and how to finish these pulls the easiest way possible. So the first couple pulls are going to be the hardest because the monsters are all at full health. You're going to get a chance to lower their health, so... The way to make the most money, though, is you are either going to need a friend that is a enchanter and a tailor. You're going to need an enchanter because you're going to need all the greens. You're going to want to get all that disenchanted and sell all that stuff in the auction house. And obviously skinning is for all this leather. You're going to need the tailor because you're actually going to want to make some bags and sell the bags. It's usually a slight more profit if you make the bags. You're going to get all the materials for the bags here, so you might as well use them. This is the hardest pull in the whole place, so this is where you want to blow like any important cooldowns you have, like this one, Army of the Dead. This is going to be the hardest pull. If you get past this, you're pretty much good to solo this place. So yeah, this place should not be a problem after this pull. If you can make it this far, then you should be good, and you shouldn't have any problems, because the pulls are going to be so much easier once you can actually ride one of these dragons. I suggest riding them just once for the quickest time, but it really, you got to lower everyone's health really low, and some of the pulls are going to be extremely easy after this pull. So everything should be really smooth after this pull. Okay guys, so this is basically the main part of this, is how quick you can do this. So basically, how well you can do it, basically. So you need to get really good at doing this. And I haven't done this in a long time, but it's going to take some practice to be able to get the most out of this. What you want to do is make sure that you don't actually kill anything. You just want to get everything to extremely low health, and that's going to be the best way. Because if these guys are high health, this is going to be a much harder run and go much slower. So basically, you just pull up to right here. That's going to be the last pull. This part over here, you can't really go any further and make a lot of money because of the next boss will be in the way. And pretty much that's where you end it, and you go out and restart again. Just reset the instance. Should take about 15 minutes. Might take slightly longer. And the practice on this part is going to be key in how quick you do it. Because if you can get them, if you're real good at it, I admit I'm not the best. If you can do it super good and get everything to almost zero health, then you can just basically bust through it in probably a little over 10 minutes. So... the quicker you can do this, the better. Obviously, you'll get better at it the more you do it. So let's see if I can get the health on these guys down a little bit. You got to be prepared to do this right the second that they're in range. And I need to get these guys as low as possible just so we can run this the best. This is the way you're going to make the most money, is by lowering the health of these guys. So keep doing this. This is going to be the key. If you don't do well, you can still finish the instance. It's just going to be a little bit slower. So basically, guys, there isn't much to show here. Basically, these guys are half health. You pull everything all the way to the end. I'll just show you the end, and if there's anything important, I'll show that to you guys. But basically, just pull every group, and that's it. So guys, once you finish this last pull right here, the one right next to the boss, that is when you want to head back. And if you notice, I skipped the pull right at the beginning. I usually do that one last because you get to damage them a bit from the dragons. So you want to do that one last. Makes more sense that way because they're already damaged. So after that, on the way out, you want to run back there and do that last pull. One last thing worth pointing out, guys, is it's probably best to target the casters. They seem to go down a lot quicker than everyone else, so it may be in your best interest if you're having trouble to definitely go for those first. And as you can see, they go down pretty quickly compared to the other guys, so I don't know, it'll help you a little bit. Now that I'm done, we can take a quick look at the inventory, see what I got. Everything in this first inventory I didn't have before, so I got one green, two greens, three greens. I got three greens, plus I got two Elementium lockboxes, so there is a chance at perhaps a blue. You are going to get some blue drops here. You want to make sure you sell those in the auction house and do not disenchant those. Usually get about a couple hundred gold for something like that. If you happen to get a trinket, you may get around 1,000 gold, which it will happen if you're running this a lot, obviously. So I got almost a stack of this, a little over half a stack of this. I got almost two stacks of Ember Silk cloth. You probably will have enough here to make an Ember Silk bag and sell that. Probably got 100 gold just from this. Not the best run, but if you do this four times, if you think about it, it's about 400 gold from gold drops, from greens and stuff. The green stuff really adds up from disenchanting that I don't know what the price is on everyone's servers, but the Greater Celestials usually go for almost 100 gold, and the Dust goes for almost 200 gold on this server. So you normally will make around 4,000 gold. Based on how your drops are. You will get as low as 2,000, and you will get as high as 6,000. So, hope this helps you guys. See you later.